Hello!
Hey guys, and welcome to my channel and to this video. For today, I was thinking we could be doing another door, a little bit looser painting. I hope you will have fun and enjoy it. I did do my sketch earlier, so it is available for download from my website. There is a link down in the description box. So if you want to download it for yourself, find the link, go ahead, download it, trace it, and we can get started. Today I will be using this Fontaine watercolor paper. It is 300 GSM and 140 pounds, 100% cotton, 18 by 24 centimeters or 7 by 9.5 inches. It is a cold press watercolor paper. And for the watercolors, I will be using my own watercolors that I made myself, but I will guide you through the colors, through the entire painting process. First, I started with pre-wetting that yellow wall and afterwards picked up a yellow. This is something like actually a rose sienna and cadmium yellow medium, mix of those two, and painted in the wall, the entire wall. I did not try to skip those parts that were representing the part that is lightened by the sun. And the other parts are actually shadow. I painted in everything in the same color. And then with this clean brush, I'm picking up the paint on the parts that should be a little bit lighter. But I was thinking to myself later on, I was sorry that I just did not paint one entire wash, light wash for the entire wall, left it to dry completely, and then went with a little bit of the darker paint in the parts that should be in shadow and painted it that way. Because now when I'm looking at my finished piece, it just looks like there is some stains on the wall and not really that there is a game of light and shadows. So I would definitely change the way that I painted that. When finished with that, I've just added a little bit of the water around the pot, and with green and the tip of my brush, added it here and there just to paint in the greenery in my pot. When finished with that, I've mixed in some turquoise blue and painted in the doors, and every part that you can see that is turquoise, I've painted it straight away. And as I was painting it, I was just adding a little bit more and a little bit less paint here and there. I wasn't trying to make one even wash, so at the end it dried a little bit different on some places, and that's exactly what you should try to do here. And if it turns out to be exactly the same, it doesn't matter, you can just add a little bit more paint in some parts. And if it turns out as mine, somewhere a little bit lighter, some a little bit darker, that's also fine. On the corners of the doors, I've added a little bit of the darker paint, and for the ground and the wall on the left side, I've painted in somewhat a grayish color in my mix of yellow. I've added a little bit of blue, a little bit of brown, just to make that color a little bit grayish. I did want that wall to be quite lighter, and just to make that yellow wall pop up. And when it all dried completely, I moved on to the second layer for my wall. And as I said, it just wasn't turning out the way I wanted it. I wasn't painting those shadows the way I actually was planning to do. So I was thinking to myself, well, I should have done that way. I should have just done it one light wash and then on top added the darker shadows, maybe a little bit more details. But, you know, at the end, it is what it is. I do like how it turned out. It just wasn't exactly the thing I was planning to paint. Now I've picked up a little bit of the black with this smaller flat brush, and just with a tip of brush, I'm tapping in those creases on the doors. And I'm not trying to paint in one straight line, but I'm just tipping with the brush and just adding a little bit more of the paint here and a little bit less there, because I do want it to make it feel like there are all the doors cracked and it has everything tear and wear from the time on it. So I wasn't trying to paint one straight line. For the doorway, I'm again using the same colors that I did use for the ground, and for that left wall, a little bit lighter color on that front part and a little bit darker on the side part. And I will be adding a little bit, as you could have seen, a little bit of darker pigment, because I do want it to make it look, it is a 3D and it is on the side, a little bit more of the shadow. For the inside of the doors, inside of the house, that is, painting in with black. And again, I did drew this those ornaments as you will see on the sketch, but maybe, you know, you should be careful when you do this. Maybe you should draw it a little bit more detailed, because I just drew it as one line, and then when I started to add colors here, black color, it just really didn't, because you can see it really didn't turn out as the sketch. But if you have maybe if you have masking fluid or masking marker, you can mask this part while still white, paint it with black, and then remove the masking fluid. I think that would definitely be the easier thing. Or maybe add on top a little bit of white gouache or a little bit of white gel pen to paint in those ornaments on the doors. For the pot, I'm using this somewhat a brick color, and if you don't have something similar to that, you can use a burnt sienna. That would be just fine, burnt sienna. And on the parts just beneath the leaves, I've painted in a little bit darker to make it look as though it is in shadow, and also the right part a little bit darker, and just beneath it I've added a little bit of the black and painted in the shadow. For the leaves, I did add a little bit, first a little bit of lighter green leaves, and then added a little bit of the black and painted in the darker leaves, making them look like they are again in the shadow. And for the flowers, I'm using this violetish color, red violet color, and I've just added here and there flowers, then sprinkled some more, then topped in a little bit more as I wanted it. And I do want that flowers to look quite loose, like there are all over the place, so I wasn't trying to paint stems or paint perfect flowers. I was just dotting it, and I didn't want it to make it loose at the end. I do like it how it looks now. A little bit more details with this flat brush and a black color, just to make it a little bit more pop up. And then added a little bit of that yellow that I used for the wall, and I've added that yellow here and there also on the doors to again mimic some tears and wears. A little bit of black on the side part of the doorway to make it even a little bit darker. Now I will be using this cotton swab to maybe soften those shadows, because they weren't looking like shadows to me. So I decided I do wanted to soften the edges of them, made them maybe make them look like there are some tears and wears on the facade on our building, and not really some shadows and light from some tree. And picked up a little bit of around on the corners, as I said, just to make it a little bit more soft, those edges. And then with this gel pen, not really gel pen, with this ink pen, I've added a little bit more of the details, just drew in a couple of lines that were on my sketch to make them more visible on my finished piece. For this, you can, instead of an ink pen, you can again go with your flat brush or with your brush with a pointy tip, and black watercolor, that would also be just fine. I was thinking that would be that this would make my painting a little bit more sketchy, so I decided to use an ink pen. And also drew in a couple of flowers with that same ink pen, a little bit more of the sprinkles, this time this violet color, and a little bit with white gouache. You can, instead of white gouache, use here also acrylic paint. If you don't have none of that, don't worry, you can definitely skip this step. And with that, I'll be finishing off this painting in this video. Thank you guys a lot for watching, for all your support. I really do hope you like it and you enjoyed it. Maybe give this one a try. Don't forget, you have a free sketch available. And if you like this video, please hit the like button, share it, comment. And if you haven't still, please do subscribe to my channel. That really means a lot to me. Maybe even consider joining my channel. You know, that's that channel next to the subscribe. Well, click on that, listen to the offer and the site. Again, guys, thank you so much for watching, for all your support, and I hope I'll see you next time. Bye.